What's going on, guys? Welcome to another Madden 15 Ultimate Team video, and this is about 1 hour after the new positional sets have been released into the game. We got fullback and middle linebacker. So first and foremost, let's take a look at Bruce Miller, who's currently going for 790,000 coins. Now, he's got 88 speed, 93 strength, and stiff arm, but he's got 96 run block, 88 trucking. It says Miller finished second in total yards among fullbacks. 49ers halfbacks averaged 4.7 yards per carry when running behind Bruce Miller. So he gives plus 8 to ground and pound, plus 8 to speed run. There is your fullback position reward. Once again, 99 overall, and he gives 100 impact blocking as well. So there you guys have the Bruce Miller item. I love the card art, by the way. It just seems like every time a new promo comes out, it just gets better and better. But let's go ahead and refresh one more time to check out the middle linebacker, see if he pops up any cheaper. And he didn't, so he's currently going for 800,000 coins. And I noticed some people on Twitter that were a little upset by who they chose to give the 99 overall to. So let's just go ahead and take a look at him. It's DeMario Davis, and he's got 94 speed, 99 tackling and pursuit, 95 play rec, 95 block shed, zone coverage highlighted at 86. Leader of the New York Jets defense, Davis totaled 116 tackles, 4 sacks, and 41 tackles, resulted in 1 yard gain or less. So plus 8 to zone defense, plus 9 to run stuff. Once again, there is your 99 overall DeMario Davis. And it's only the second one in the game behind the Navarro Bowman that we recently had added to the throwback section of Ultimate Team. So there you guys have it. Go ahead and let me know in the comments below if this was the right decision, or if not, who would you have chosen to get a 99 overall fullback and middle linebacker? So now that we've taken a look at the 99 position rewards, let's jump over to the sets real briefly and show you guys what we're looking at. So this was at first glance who all was selling for the most coins that I noticed within these sets. So if you have them, you may want to go ahead and take a look at throwing them up on the auction block, starting with Team of the Week, James Laurinaitis. Let's look at how much he was currently going for. 34,000 coins. That's a pretty good coin amount for a gold Team of the Week that you could have laying around in your binder. And second of all, the elite Team of the Week, Chris Borland. How much is he? 58,000 coins. Sitting right at 60k a pop. So there you guys have it. Now you see that I do have, you know, a good bit of the players that go into this set. So I definitely need to start looking up some prices. Now I've thrown some of them up already. Some of them have expired. Now some of them have been getting overflowed on the auction block, everyone trying to sell at one time. So I may need to hold off a little bit on selling the rest of the items that I have here. But there's just a quick look at everything in the set. If you noticed, I know I went kind of fast, but if you noticed something that you had, you may want to log on and go ahead and sell it and make your coins. So, fullback set. We got some really high priced items within this set, and you see that I've already done the solo challenge for that as well. So here we go, guys. What is rare in this set that I've noticed right away? Well, if I can find it, let me see. Where is he? Here he is. Orson Charles, Road to the Playoffs. Look how much this is currently going for. 49,000 coins for a gold fullback. Now, if you guys have that, obviously I don't need to tell you that you should probably go ahead and sell it. And another rare that I've noticed already, Javorski Lane. Like, there's only a handful of these up as well. 60,000 coins. And it doesn't end there. I mean, we have some silver players in this set, as well as, you know, the three elites. I have John Kuhn. Marcel Reese, I believe he's selling for the most of the three like he always has. But we also have some silvers, and all of them are going for a significant amount. So let's just start it off and check out Kyle J. That's what I'm going to call him. Kyle J definitely going for a ton of coins, right at 60k. And then we also have Chris Presley in here. Where is he at? All right, here he is. There was only just a few of these up a while ago as well. And he's got a hefty price sitting at 45,000 coins. Now, all these silvers do have a good amount to them, like I said. So let's just check up on another one. Derek Coleman, for example, some of them are only like 7 or 8K. But to be silvers, they definitely have a pretty nice value. So we're just going to check up on one more and see what he's currently going for. 12,000 coins. And there you guys have it. That's what you're looking at in these sets. And you noticed, like I said, that I have done the solo for the fullback. and I do have pieces for both sets, so I need to go ahead and do the middle linebacker solo challenge to get that collectible. Reminder guys, the solo is only in the game for 1 week. After that, you cannot get that collectible, so if you're planning on doing these sets, go ahead, get the collectibles, and knock out the sets. And an update on the flashback video that I said I would upload yesterday. For some reason, YouTube would not let me upload. It has these stages where sometimes it is just basically broken for a day and it won't let you upload, and that's what happened yesterday. But I went ahead and uploaded that video earlier this morning, so if you missed it, go ahead, feel free to check that out. And there you guys have the prices on the middle linebacker and brand new 99 overall fullback. So as always, if you guys are going to be doing the sets, let me know in the comments below, or if you found some hidden gems in your binder, sell them and make that profit. And as always, I will ask that if you guys enjoyed the video to go ahead and shatter the like button and subscribe for more. So until next time guys, roll tide.